Madhushree, for inviting me to this Brand Talk, the Master Series. Very happy to be associated with this. The current situation, as you know, we are all trying to stay at home, not get out as far as possible, unless it's really, really necessary and for only essential goods that we need to buy. But otherwise, yes, this time can be used to do all those things that you really wanted to do. So I'm trying to write a book, which I always wanted to write for a long time. I'm also trying to paint. I'm also trying to do a couple of poems. And I'm also sitting and planning some new conferences and webinars, which would be very useful to our members. So we are also working from home, most of us who are at home at the moment, particularly from the trade department, from the research department, are all working from home. So as far as the operations at the World Trade Center are concerned, you know, we are to follow almost all those precautionary measures that we need to take to make sure that some of the offices which are already working there, which have never stopped working, such as the banks, we have to provide all those essential services. So some of our staff members are located at the World Trade Center since the day of the lockdown, and they have not moved out of the World Trade Center, but the precautionary measures were started much before. So let us look at what we've been doing in this lockdown period. Yeah, we at the World Trade Center have been in constant touch with all the other World Trade Centers and other industry associations and experts from different countries. We've been trying to organize webinars and virtual discussions, and they have been really successful because every such discussion has had a large number of participation from business houses and SMEs who are particularly worried about the future of their own business and how are they going to face the various challenges that they are going to face in the near future. But some of these experts who have been talking to us have been of the opinion that it may not be as difficult as we assume it's going to be or we perceive it. So we should look at such experts and probably get an idea on how we should be fighting such crisis to make sure that we lead our MSMEs in the right direction, so they make the right choices and they get all the support that is required from every aspect, that is from the banks, from the governments, from the buyers, from these raw material suppliers, from the laborers, from the working force, from the management staff, from everybody who's connected with industry in any way. So it all boils down to supporting each one of us, each other in this fight of surviving, in making sure that the industry revives and gets back to its earlier position, and the MSMEs come out more stronger than what they were before. So in these circumstances, the government of India, as well as the state government and the RBI, as well as other bankers, will play a very, very important role, because they will have to provide several other incentives, such as capital for exporters. They will have to provide capital for technology upgradation. They will have to give other incentives to make sure that the exporters are given all support needed to meet these challenges that are before them at the moment. We also need to make sure that all those online certifications are implemented at the earliest, so that exporters get the benefit of complying with the various compliances that are very important to the exporters. The exporters are indeed facing very challenging times, particularly because of the congestion of cargo at the ports. The manpower or the skilled manpower is not available. There are no truck drivers, so there is no way that they can move the cargo at the ports. And secondly, because of the shutdown, their production units are all closed, so they are not in a position to meet the export orders. So if you look at it, they are really in a very, very catch-22 situation. Although some of them have already started in the green zones their production, but this needs to be implemented in other areas as well, because if they have to fulfill their export obligations, the government also needs to look at providing them with more incentives to ensure that they have sufficient capital and they have sufficient technology to fulfill these requirements of exports as well as the online certifications, which need to be implemented immediately so that they are able to fulfill all the compliances which are required by the international buyers. There is every possibility that post-COVID, every country will try to become more and more self-sufficient. But our exporters, I do not think will have any such problem, because we are not into exports of any very high-tech materials or gadgets or products. So most of our exports are very basic in nature. It's either raw material or some intermediary product. So I really do not think that we should have any problem with our exports. We definitely need to look at expanding our exports and to increasing our exports in the wake of such crisis, because there is every possibility that we can export more health-related devices, we can export pharmaceuticals, we can export more APIs. So there is a possibility of increasing our exports in these circumstances. In fact, we can even export food, we can export other raw material which is required by the European or Latin American or the American or Americas, or you know, all those countries. Because today, if you look at it, India will become more and more competitive in the post-COVID, because as they say that every crisis brings its own opportunities. So I'm sure with COVID there will be several other opportunities opening up for Indian exporters as well as for Indian SMEs to look at not just the market within India, but to look at other markets outside India. And World Trade Center would be more than happy to identify such markets and assist them and facilitate them to take their products and services to those countries wherever we feel that there is a great potential for them. MSMEs in India today should be able to make the most of it out of this crisis, because if you look at the 56 companies which have moved out of China, most of them have gone to Vietnam, or some 10 to 11 have gone to Taiwan, and about 8 have gone to Thailand, and only 3 of them have come to India. So this just shows that our MSMEs are not really geared to work with such challenges which are required by international investors. So we should look at skill development, we should look at more technological upgradations, we should be looking at identifying our own manufacturers with whom we should be able to strengthen our supply chains. MSMEs today are in a very, very strong position, because Indian market itself is a very huge market. So if they are able to compete and even get the business within India itself, MSMEs will do very well, because India is such a huge country, and there is no way that MSMEs in India cannot compete with whatever was being imported by Indian companies. So particularly all that raw material which we were importing from China and other countries can definitely be manufactured here, and this will make in India also a very successful initiative. And as the government is already promising various incentives, MSME should be able to make the most of this opportunity and come out more successful. I wish them all the very best. Post-COVID, I hope we all realize the importance of living a very conscious life. We should understand the importance of this lockdown and take a lesson from here to make sure that the generations to come live a very healthy life and do not face such pandemics again.